Hello everyone, and welcome back to another GTA Online guide video. Today I'm making the last of a racing trilogy of videos. All about racing, would you believe? And in this video I'll be taking a look at some other aspects of racing that I either couldn't fit in the other videos, or just plain forgot to include. So let's get right to it. This video is going to be more about racing that isn't about car racing. And on that note, let's talk about boat racing. The ideal boat that you'll want to use is something with a really long body, such as the dinghy, the speeder, or the Toro, due to their large bodies being capable of the trick that I'm about to show you. Basically, as you drive along the water, especially over choppy water, where the boat is bouncing around all the time, what you want to do as you drive in a straight line is hold back on the analog stick. This will lean the boat back and keep the rotors of the engine in the water, providing you with a small speed boost as you fly through the air over the waves. Now over time, this will allow you to easily outrun anyone who's just driving normally, and is something you should always do whenever you're in a boat race. I wouldn't try leaning back as you're taking a sharp corner, otherwise your boat won't turn as tight as it should, and you can end up missing a checkpoint and ruin your race. Now let's briefly talk about helicopter racing. A lot of times where you do a helicopter race, you may end up in a GTA race, which means missiles galore, in which case you need to hold back at the start of the race and let all of the players in front get taken out by the missiles. The ideal helicopter for both GTA and non-GTA helicopter races would be the Buzzard. Its ability to avoid missiles under the skillful control of its pilot, and the general high acceleration and agility makes it the clear choice if you're wondering which helicopter is ideal for helicopter racing. Now a lot of you will be thinking, what about the Volatus? Well, although the Volatus is a very quick helicopter in a straight line, it pales in comparison to the Buzzard when it comes to everything else. So all in all, for helicopter races, always choose the Buzzard. Now, on to the final tip for this video, or trick, depending on how you look at it. For the record, I would never recommend you do this unless you're racing against someone like this. In which case, this is right up your alley. I'm going to show you how to pit maneuver someone. Again, this is something that you should never do in a normal race, because it's very unsportsmanlike, it ruins the fun if you do it to everyone, and should only be done to people who do it to you first. Alright then, as you drive up to your opponent, what you want to try and do is get your front end of the car nice and close to the rear side of the opponent's car. And it's important that you get really close. When you're in position, sharply turn into the car and hopefully the rival car should spin out in front of you and then clear out of the way. Ideally, you need to do this on a straight road with plenty of room to make sure that you don't end up crashing yourself. There's a lot of things that can go wrong when doing a pit on someone, although it can be mostly just drive error, such as if you attempt to slam into the other car into the corner. Yes, you'll take him out, but you'll also take yourself out in the process. So now you know how to correctly pit someone off the road, but as always, I recommend you only do this when it's absolutely necessary. Just keep the sport of racing clean, okay? And on that note, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new to the Pyrone Gaming channel for loads more GTA Online guides coming to you very soon. See you around!